What's up, guys? That Really Gross Guy here, and boy, do I have a treat for you today. In fact, it's a treat for me, too, because I have been in two games, maybe three games so far with this new Mirage, and I am having a blast. And it's mostly because I don't even have to think about what I'm doing anymore. I don't have to. Just wait and see. All right. So, hey, don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare. I totally should have used my first ability. All right, that's okay. We'll just have everyone flood in this room, and we'll just wreck their face. So, Lotus, could you please shut up? Because that's like 25 lines of dialogue, and I'm not having it. I'm not having it right now. I don't want to hear your voice. I don't want to hear it, Lotus. She just had like an essay. She just wrote an essay and just recited. Oh my God. Be quiet. Anyways, here we are. Look at this Mirage. Okay, so real quick, I want to mention to you guys that there is a skin in, oh goodness, there's a bomb. There is a skin in it's called Technodrome. It is in the workshop right now being voted on, and it's been retouched a couple times by the author. And a lot of people are saying it's a little too busy. I get where they're coming from. They're saying it's a little too busy. You know, even DE might be like, hey, you know, that's a pretty tough skin to just pour it over. So maybe it needs to be dialed down a little bit. But to be honest with you, I'm really liking the skin. It's got a little bit of, like I said, a little bit of hate because they're like, oh, it's too busy. They tone it down and it'll be better, this or that. I want this skin for Mirage. It looks very, I guess, kind of cyberpunk. It is one of my favorite skins, and it's not even in the game yet. It's one of my favorite looking skins I've seen personally. And this person is, it appears like they, I don't know if they've done any other skins that have made it yet, but this one looks professionally done. It really does. It looks great. And it's one that I am highly considering picking up. I hate the price. I hate the price that these things cost, but to be honest, this thing looks fantastic, and it will take over the skin on this Mirage specifically. I want to keep like a blue, metallic-y, almost like Prisma look to it, but I guess there isn't really a Prisma color to Mirage, but with these things on the side and all that, her little doppelgangers on the side, I want this one to be a very Prisma cyberpunk-esque kind of build. And I think, number one, this skin will help me do that, and I'm just really excited. I'm really excited. So the skin will change. The colors won't change too drastically. Obviously, they will, because the colors will be in different locations when the skin comes out. But I think it looks great. Look at that scheme. I think that color scheme is great. I'm using Prisma Shade. Let me get this Doppelganger ability back up. I'm using the Prisma Shade because, number one, I need mastery rank. Number two, I think it fits pretty well. And I love Shade's ability to cloak, so that's pretty fantastic as well. I haven't really done so much because I'm so excited for this build. I'm having a blast. So as you can see, I don't have to think a whole lot playing through here because, number one, the Cynoid Simular, everyone knows, super good, very powerful, and I haven't gotten it just because at first I was like, I just want to stray away from like not having to think playing Warframe. And now that I've had to farm as crazy as I've had to these last few Borrow visits and Prime Access and all that stuff, I decided to kind of cave and just say, you know what, I need something that can get the job done that I don't need to think about. That's one reason why I did a lot of Ember in the Void, is because her World on Fire just made you super powerful, and very little thought had to go into your gameplay. And after I realized that, I was like, I'm already kind of doing that with Ember. I might as well cave. I might as well do what a lot of people do with Mirage and just go Cyanoid Simular and just wreck these guys. Because I'm only level 12, so I only have the two doppelgangers. But look at that. Look at that. They merge, especially when you get multi-shot on this thing. These things merge like crazy, and they just destroy everything. Granted, I'm in a low-level Fissure mission, but I'm also only a level 12 Mirage. So when this thing gets some form into it and gets all of her doppelgangers and obviously all of her mods inside of her, I now understand why people flock to this type of build with Mirage. I liked her as kind of a jester. I even decided to use her with the Tonkor to kind of be, you know, have a little bit of fun, just having explosives going off and bouncing explosives down the corridor and just watching things blow up. This bombard really wasn't even that big of a problem. I wasn't doing a whole ton of damage to him, but I was messing him up, to be honest with you. Once you get all the status you want into these builds, and once you, like I said, the mods that just make her as powerful as she can be. Watch this Nullifier get wrecked. Gone. These guys that have just spawned in, pretty much wrecked. I still got 100 rounds. Just wrecked. So I'm loving it. I'm loving it at the moment. Let me get a reload. Watch this. Just toasted those guys. This heavy gunner, he'll go down. Two more shots. Heavy gunner down. Easy peasy. I'm having a great time. And let me show you something else I decided to do. I don't know if this is a thing. It probably is. I remember someone talking about using, I think, the Penta or the Tonkor with Mirage and just having... Or no, was it a melee weapon? I remember what they used to do is they used to run towards enemies, and it works with the Staticore. I will show you. So run towards enemies, especially when you have all your doppelgangers, and just blast the ground. Just blast the ground. Obviously, you know, I'm a low rank, so it's definitely going to get more powerful in time. But you just run around, blast the ground a bunch of times, and you toast these guys. Granted, I only have radiation on, so it's not going to do much to these corpus. But, let's see. It's not quite as good as the Simular is yet. Simular is just super OP. But I think the Staticore is praised pretty well because it is pretty good. Granted, it might fall off in the long run. I'm not too sure about all that. And how can you say no to a freaking Kamehameha weapon like this? Blah! Wait. It takes travel time. You can reduce the travel time or fire or whatever to get that to do more whatever. But or a Ryu from Street Fighter. Wait. Hadouken! Boom. Explosion. I killed everybody but the... Oh, not everybody, but I killed... Yeah, I did end up getting him. I didn't kill the Ancient, but I took those guys down. This thing does go up. Does go up pretty strong. See? Okay, well, it's an Ancient. There's only so much you can say. I'm loving it. Put some mods on these. You are going to see this Mirage much more. To be honest, the reason why I'm showing you her at this low of a level is just, number one, to show that she's a little bit OP in this configuration, and at the same time, I just couldn't wait. I'm having a blast. I'm just running around, just blasting these guys. Obviously, nullifiers can be a bit of a problem. Whatever. And that's why, finally, we'll get into the Prisma dual cleavers, which are wrecking these guys, destroying these guys, mostly because it can use the Steel Meridian augment, and it's working. The status blasts and all that stuff, fantastic. What else? The Cyanoid Simular has its own status proc thing. And let me do this. Get all these guys. and these cameras. Come on back, guys. Come on. Oh, don't bounce over there. That's not helping me out at all. Okay. Okay. Watch that thing bounce around for a little while. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. Let me switch over to the Cynoid Simular. Boom, boom, boom. Bye-bye, Nully. Bye-bye, Nully. Need to get this back up. Pop, pop, pop. No more Nully. He's dead. Gosh, Mirage is so good in this configuration. Anyways, let's go through here. Let's actually do the mission now that I just had a nice fanboy moment. I always knew Mirage was good. Like I said, people love this configuration. I always knew this was a good way to do it. I just held out for so long and didn't go this route, mostly because I didn't have the Cynoid Simular, and I didn't want to just run missions without thinking. But to be honest, like I said, if you're sick of farming and putting so much thought into your gameplays and you wanna, because they're not gonna change the farming. They're not just gonna give you every prime access when it comes out. That's not gonna happen. If you want to get through more high-end missions and you wanna think a lot less, this is a good way to do it. Good way to do it. Granted, I don't have first-hand experience with that, so take it with a grain of salt. I mean, I haven't done it myself. I've seen people do it. I've almost everyone that, I don't want to say everyone, but a lot of the guys that do farm, I've seen using Mirage in, I don't want to say this configuration, because I don't know if they're using the static core. I don't know if they're using the Prisma Dual Cleavers, but definitely the Cynoid Simular, if they have it, or just the Simular. They're both good, but obviously the Cynoid is much better. Get out of here, bro. Get out of here. Break all these stuff. Break all these stuff. Hey, you. Hey, you. All right, they're dead. All right. So, it's a good way to go. It's a good way to go. And bam, bam, bam. Oop, there we go. Awesome, 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 awesome. Let's grab this. And after we grab this, all right. I don't really actually need this one because, oh, you know, because I only need one to get the job done. Bam, bam, and bam, 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 bam. I need my one ability. I keep forgetting that. That's one thing I need to get used to, is keeping her one ability going pretty much at all times. All right, bam, move that, move that, move that. But yeah, farming is going to be easier from now on. You'll see her a little bit more often. I also don't want to turn my gameplays and my daily stuff into thoughtless gameplays, you know what I mean? So you're not, she's not going to be my main, so if you guys really like her, you know, I'll use her some more, and like I said, I plan on doing some of my farming with her. But for the most part, I don't ever want to feel burnt out, so I don't want to just mindlessly be doing missions over and over and over and over and over again. Unless I'm, like I said, I'm farming for stuff, which I pretty much do anyways with Ember. So we'll still continue to do I don't want to say difficult missions, but we'll do productive missions. I do want to go through and maybe do all the bosses, maybe solo all the bosses. I would like to show you guys maybe how I go about doing some of these bosses, or how, because a lot of them end up being like my Mesa, because my Mesa is just, she's so good, and with her one ability and the Grinlock, she puts down a ton of damage on enemies. So it's a nice theme, I guess. It's really enjoyable. I love it. So we'll do that. We'll go through the remainder of my missions that I have not, my quests that I have not done yet. And I guess, what else could we do? What else could we do? We got those. Maybe we'll do sorties from time to time. That's the thing. I haven't been doing sorties because I have most of what the sorties drop. The only thing I think I need is one part for, like, the Dare of Vandal. And, I mean, I'd like to have it. I'd like to have it for Mastery. I heard it's actually pretty good. I heard it's actually a strong weapon, so I don't want it for just Mastery fodder. But I do definitely want to get it to level 30 so I can use the Mastery fodder, or, you know, Mastery rank out of it. But, yeah, see, like, I'm a relatively low level, and I'm just, like, blasting these guys. Obviously, these corrupted MOAs can probably get the better of me. Bombards might be able to get the better of me. But even these Staticores, at this low of a level, are just, like, staggering some of these guys. Not letting them get accomplished what they want to get accomplished. It's just so good. It's so fun. I can even do this from time to time. Get you guys in the groove, fighting each other. I also soloed with Ivara, the arena. And I kind of wanted to show you guys that, but it's very lengthy. It took me like 30 minutes to solo it by myself. And no one wants to see that. And it's not worth your time doing it solo, because if you jump in with a good crew, you can burn through the arena in maybe 10 minutes. Granted, you know, it could take longer or shorter depending on if you have a good team. But yeah, you guys don't want to sit there and watch me solo it for oh boy, I just got, okay, I might go down because the oxygen is sucked out of the room. Yeah, that's what I thought. Oxygen was sucked out of the room. It is what it is. Let's get this going. I need some efficiency if I'm going to be using my ultimate. I haven't decided if I want to mod for my ultimate or if I just want to do a doppelganger tanky mirage or not efficient mirage, but like a, I don't know. But I don't know. I hope you guys enjoyed. We are getting close to the end. I am about to, hopefully tomorrow, I hate to throw new themes at you back to back, but this one is a big deal, and the next one is a really big deal, and I'm going to throw a hint out there because you guys saw it in the last video. I got all the Prime Access parts, and that includes Necros Prime. So I want to get a Necros theme out to you guys, and it may not be what you expect, because a lot of people are going to go to town on his ultimate ability, and I really don't even want to use his ultimate ability. I don't want to design him for his ultimate ability, because I don't find that type of... I like summoners in most games, but in Warframe, I like to be either more tanky or stealth-oriented. I don't like to be someone who's in the crowd but not doing the action. That's just... I don't really care for it. But I want to do a warrior-based Necros. A health, energy, absorbing, obviously using his Desecrate like crazy, but I want to tank him up and have him in the heart of the battle. I want him to be as close to a Rhino tank, a Naros tanky kind of build as I can, without sacrificing his abilities. But then again, I'm not using his ult, so I don't know. You guys can be the judge of whether you like it or not, but to be honest, I'm going to play how I feel like playing, because that's what keeps Warframe interesting to me, is the different ways you can build a Warframe and still be useful. Granted, my Necros without his ultimate ability might not be super endgame ultimate whatever, but I don't care. As long as when I go into a mission that I feel like doing, he's gonna make it from start to finish. That's all I care about. So anyways, just a vigor. I don't really need it. Maybe I'll go get it. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you like this Mirage. Thumbs up if you do. Let me know if you want to see some more of her. And honestly, I don't know this guy that's doing the new skin, but I highly suggest checking him out. And if you like it, let people know. Let people know that you want to see it in-game, because I want to see it in-game. And if you do too, let's see it make it, because it is very well done. Very well done. And hopefully you guys are interested. If you're a Mirage player, I think you'll like it. Or Cyberpunk. Anyways, thank you guys. That was a long outro. Hope you enjoyed. And until next time, Paris Prime Upper Limb. No thank you. I'll take it for ducats, but meh. All right. That was long. I'm sorry. Until next time. Blah! Fantastic. Syndicate Explosion 2. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Let's go here. Boom, boom, boom. Open that. All right. Let's peace. Let's go. Charlie's usually the last. I don't know. Yeah.